How does our tool help you further professionalize project and program management? Hello, I'm Odo Klöcker from the European Center for Digital Transformation. In the next 6 minutes, I'll describe some of the key features of our portfolio management tool for project managers and other project participants. Namely, how to view and update a project, how to manage the project's dependencies, how to use the workflow to request an approval, how to manage workflow requests you have received, and how to create a new project. Let's begin. In this home view, you can see the list of projects you are involved in, including the most important info here, ID, name, the current risk score, and gates and their dates. The colors directly draw your attention to the upcoming deadlines and dates that are overdue. To view one of these projects, you click on the name. For instance, launch iPhone 6. This project belongs to the sub-portfolio consumer and is in progress. As you can see, projects in this portfolio have 8 info sections on the main page. You can view them using the tab bar or by just scrolling down. Please note that for every portfolio, you can define the structure of its items, such as the projects, according to the demands of your organization. So the name and number of sections, the order, and what's in it. In this view, you can also change the data of the project. The timeline section shows recent activities that are associated with this project. For instance, also things like a new red risk in a sub-project. This way, you can catch up really easily on recent changes. This timeline information is generated automatically, since the system already knows what has been changed. You can also post a comment on this project. In the organization section, all colleagues that participate in this project are administered, each of them in the specific role that they hold in this project. You can, for instance, add a business analyst by simply clicking in the field. The charter type project infos are specified in the description section. In the budget and gates section, the current planning is maintained and approvals are documented. Previous plans or approvals can be viewed using the drawer button. Budget can be structured in different categories, for example, CapEx and OPEX, IT and engineering, or per fiscal year. The document section allows you to store and retrieve key project documents. Also, a template can be fetched here. To sign off documents, the workflow functionality can be used. By the way, in the first line, the tool generated decision documents that were used to request the budget and gate approval are stored automatically. You can also manage your risks in the risks and issues section. You use the plus button to add a new risk, and you can request someone to take responsibility using the workflow. In the progress section, project deliverables or tasks can be managed. The level of detail is up to you. Again, you will use the workflow to assign responsibility. You can also capture planned, already delivered, and remaining efforts per task. The last update in this section occurred on May 25th. By the way, this last update info can be turned on and off for each of the sections. So now I showed you how to view and edit a project. Let's switch to part 2 in this demo on the dependencies of projects. This project has several dependencies to other items that are managed with this tool. Let's have a look. On the dependencies page, you again see several sections. Subprojects, main projects, releases, predecessors, successors, NPS and skills. The project has 2 sub-projects and belongs to the main project New Sales Strategy. The project is linked to the April release, which will launch on April 22nd. The development effort in this release for this project is 85 man days. The project's visual mailbox and ERP upgrade are predecessors. Good to know that both their status is green. There are no successors to this project. The iPhone project has impact on 5 KPIs as the NPS section shows. And the project requires several skills. For instance, 45 man days of a business analyst in the project phases feasibility and specification. With this, I conclude the overview on the dependencies of projects and switch to the workflow of our portfolio management tool. Let me show you how you can use the workflow, for example, to get a gate and budget approval. You press the stamp button on top of the gate section. You now see previous approval requests for gates and their status. You can also view other workflow requests. Let's assume you would like to create an approval request for the next gate, including budget. You choose the budget and gate section and press plus to add another request. You first have to choose whether you want to request a pre or final approval. If you choose final approval, you will then have to choose the approver. The tool now provides a preview of the email that will be sent to Mark van der Paas. And you have the chance to include further colleagues to be informed, add a comment, or attach further documents out of the project's document section. Mark now will receive an email with all relevant info and can approve or reject the request via email, or via the tool if that is his preference. In My To-Dos, you can view and manage workflow requests you have received or risks or tasks that you have taken responsibility for. You can answer workflow requests, including a comment, either here or via the email you received. This brings me to the final topic of this video, the creation of a new project. If you want to create a new item, you can do so wherever you are on the tool by clicking on the plus button in the top menu bar. You choose the type of the item by selecting the portfolio, then the subportfolio, and then you decide on a name and press save. You will then get to fill out the item's details. And that's it for this video. If you want to know more, check out our webpage, give us a call or send us an email. We are happy to hear from you.